So these accounting records are typically a small amount of binary data with the name of the command, the amount of CPU time used, the user ID and group ID, the starting time and so on. So in the process accounting, what all things we will be maintained? We will be maintaining the CPU time, user and user ID, group ID of the process, starting time and ending time of the process. So these are the things we will be recording in the process accounting. A super user executes account on ACCT on with a path name argument to enable accounting. So a super user can execute account on with the path name argument to enable accounting. Using the account on, we can enable the account process accounting. The accounting records are written to the specified file, which is usually var account ACCT. So all these things will be recorded where? It will be recorded in the path name var account ACCT. Accounting is turned off by executing account on without any argument. Once if a process accounting is done, you can turn off using the account on command. Now data required for the accounting record, such as CPU time, number of characters transferred, is kept by the kernel in the process table and initialized whenever a new process is created, as in the child after a fork. So all these data need to be recorded. What all things? Accounting, CPU time, number of characters transferred, all these things will be maintained by the kernel. Each accounting record is written when the process terminates. Now, this is very, very important point, students, you can understand that whenever process gets created, that time process accounting doesn't get created. Whenever process terminates, whenever a process gets terminated, that time only a process record process accounting will be recorded. And this means that the order of the records in the accounting file corresponds to the termination order of the process, not the order in which they were started. So it means the accounting will be created in order of the termination of the process, not in the order of creation of the process. If a process has been created later but it got terminated early, then this process accounting will be created for this process first. Similarly, if a process A has been created first, process B has been created second, but process A has been terminated late, then process B, A, process accounting of process A will be created later. The accounting records correspond to processes, not programs. So, a process accounting will be corresponding to the processes, not for the programs. Processes are nothing but it is a acting form of or execution form of the program. A new record is initialized by the kernel for the child after a fork, not when a new program is executed. A new record is initialized by kernel for the child after a fork, not when a new program is executed. once the child, once after executing the fork function, child process will be created and a new record will be initialized. Now in the record, in the account, what all things are there? The structure of accounting record is defined in the header sys account.h, and it looks like account flag, account stat, account UID, account GID. So all these things will be there. Like this is what it is, a flag. Then AC underscore stat, it termination status of signal and core flag only. AC underscore UID, it's a real user ID. AC underscore GID, real group ID, and AC underscore TTY, it's a controlling terminal. So all these variables will be recorded in the account process accounting. It is a data structure. So this account flag, it can have a fork, ASU, a compat, a core, AX, SIG, and AE, X, PND. So a fork, in a process is the result of fork, but never called execute function. And if flag is ASU, means process used super user privilege, and if the account flag is a compat, means process used compatibility mode, a core means process dumped core, AX SIG process was killed by a signal, and AEX PND expanded accounting entry. Now let us understand the process accounting with one program, how in what order it gets created. Now suppose integer main PID underscore T, PID, we have defined a variable PID, and we are creating a child process PID equal to fork. If it less than 0, means error has occurred and child process has not been created. But if PID is greater than 0, not equal to 0, then it is, means it is a parent process. We are making the parent process for sleep for 2 seconds and we are exiting with its status 2. Similarly, next is for the child process which has been created here. In the child process, first child, so PID equal to fork. In the first child also we are creating a child process, another child process, less than 0, then error system, fork error. And else if PID greater than 0, means this is the first child only, a sleep for an abort. We are terminating with the abort signal for the first child. And if, then this is the second child. In the second child, if PID equal to 4, in the second child, we are creating the third child. Error system, fork error. Else if PID is not equal to 0, we are executing in the third child, we are executing bin DD, DD. If this file we are executing, then exit 7, we are exiting 7. Then this is the second child. Now in the third child, which has been created here, we are writing, again we are creating another fourth child, PID equal to 4, less than 0, error sys, fork error. Else if PID is not equal to 0, then sleep 8 and exit 0. Means here we are talking about the third child only. So total four child are created. So let us see, and sleep 6. Sleep 6, fourth child, we are making sleep 6 and we are killing with get PID, seek kill and exit. That is the fourth child. Let us see in what order. So first parent process has been created here. Here parent process, child process is created, and for the parent process we are making sleep with exit 2. Here sleep with exit 2. Then this parent process has created a child process, that is the first child process, and